represent what we have been doing in terms of innovation along the 4 years of the last action. So that is it. The innovation committee, so I'm the leader of it. I represent probably this outline. I will try just to refresh the objective of this innovation committee. Three main problems, not for the finances to be innovation, internship, and destination. Then a little bit of focus on the industry innovation data, which is something that concept that was introduced during the last year, it's still ongoing. And also try to show some deliverables that were defined as the output for the innovation along this cost action. So in terms of objective, so basically in the calling with some amount of standards, the innovation committee advises the steering committee conjunction with the advisory board in regard to the dissemination of innovation. So this was a structure that was presented on the first workshop of the construction in Copenhagen in 2015. So basically, as you can see here, the main perspective that was defined for the innovation committee was to look in three main dimensions of innovation. But also linked very well with the partnership, so industry, and of course the similarities along the network, and also not only in terms of space, but also in time frame to push this beyond the time frame of the construction. So in terms of innovation, also I present this table that was also presented in the first workshop in Copenhagen in 2015, where the innovation committee suggest some approaches for it. So this is the list. And then I'll try just to highlight things that in the opinion of the committee went better, went not so better, and something that perhaps should push forward. So in green I can highlight things that went very well in Germany. So I think we missed, even yesterday we saw a portfolio of aspects, where we see clearly fit applications also from my thing. The fact that these studies have been pushed to conference papers and even journal papers, as we yesterday also said that we are preparing a special issue in the scientific journal, shows that gives evidence that the challenges are being pushed and trying to solve. I think all the meetings that we have had along these 4 years, we have very good conversation as well. We were also able to bring into the action the experience of the industry side. So, as a successful case, the last workshop was in Lisbon, hosted by an industry partner. Also, think one thing that we are pushing since the last year maybe, is trying to address this value information issue also from industrial perspective. So this is quite theoretical, this framework of the value information. But I think since the, if you think about that, we are talking about applications on real structure, where these people, there are people that are responsible for the management and they are obliged to have the responsibility and the performance, we need to take into account in this formulation this industrial perspective and the concerns. And also, as a last point, innovation plays, that were also mentioned in that workshop in Copenhagen 2015. It was successfully being implemented, mainly during the last year, with this concept of the industry initiative. But of course, it's not only to say what went so good, we can also say what perhaps could be better, and we can learn about for the future. And mainly, I think this issue of highlighting the perspective of the industry side, of that, their problems, what they are facing in terms of needs, per year, and perhaps the outputs at the end of construction could be even better. But this is not a critique for construction, this is, I think, a learning process for the future. This is what I understand. Something that was not done, but it was suggested, is just try to promote some prizes and awards inside of the construction. For example, something like the best choice of recognition, the best paper, the best power presentation. This could, I think, perhaps challenge more people to invest, perhaps, in terms of their commitment, in terms of participating more effectively in the construction. But again, maybe in the future, in another construction, this could be also explored. So, in entrepreneurship power, again, a set of activities were suggested. Again, as you can see, I highlighted in green all of the issues related with the participation of the industry. And I think one of the things that went very well, I think, at least what I understand from my conversations with people, were the social recognitions in industry environment. So, not only promoting people moving from a research institute or a university to another, but trying to link this by using this mechanism of the social recognition, pushing people from both sides, so either from the industry or from the research side, and try to establish a short-term cooperation period to address a specific problem, again, trying to formulate this value information issue also in the perspective of the concerns of the public stakeholders. Something that we are now pushing, I will present later, it's about proposal for the research. But also, I think not only, it should not be only focusing on research or, let's say, funding from, for example, our horizontal perspective. But I think also we should push these industrial partners also to invest for us in some money. Because they are the end users of these systems, and the model of information is, I think, ultimately valuable for their benefit. If we could succeed better in this performance in terms of effectively showing evidence, announcing that company X on the right was engaged during this construction, they decided to invest on this issue of other information for the future, that would be an excellent idea. Well, I can say that Prisa, which is a partner of this construction, has recently invested in a big project for the next 5 years, where they were effectively using monitoring as a benefit to improve their asset management procedures. And this should be announced, I think, also in the construction, showing that there are industrial partners that are, from their own point, investing on the SHM towers, extracting volume information from this system. Then from the destination power, well, this was yesterday, they were addressed by the European. So, I will not extend too much. But one of the things that I think also yesterday was mentioned by our colleague, is assessing the degree of dissemination, which I think we should also try to look at this in a better way when we are now reaching the end, having some mechanisms, as in Facebook, but in that case they have some tools that can, let's say, see the progress of the dissemination and the track record of what is happening. But also I think it would be nice, I don't think it's possible, I think it's very difficult, even the cost website.
Yeah, oh. I know that it can be done, but yeah. Yeah,
more difficult and not perhaps in the time frame of 4 years. So to evaluate how things were before this construction and after the construction in terms of the paradigms. So try to see how far, let's say, this issue of the value of connection by the supermarket effectively contributed an impact on the real economy in the different dimensions, either in the industry, in the schools, in the generic awareness of the public. I think we should also try to put a little bit this in that direction, because this is impact. So, and I'm pretty sure that if we follow that, we don't forget this, that this dimension. I'm sure that all of us will benefit in terms of having a better future in using these issues that we are addressing on the part of information for estrogen at the whole levels of our society. Ultimately, one of the things that I'm very sensitive to as well, for example, is about job creation. So, I think even yesterday I was discussing how to be helmet. For example, the new generation of civil engineers, not only civil, but this was the context, should be more prepared and more aware of how to use these techniques. Apply, for example, as a panel, because my experience is that we are very conservative in the approaches when you deal with this issue of asset management. So do inspections, know what you have. So if a person retires, he takes all that know-how home and there is a point in this. So I think we need also to work in that direction. And the new generation that come out from universities, not only universities, but in this case as a civil engineering degree, should be more better prepared and be more comfortable as well in using these techniques and also to facilitate in integrating these in the real economy by new jobs in terms of the expertise, skills, whatever. So I think this should be something that we should add perhaps beyond the time frame of the construction. Of course, we're trying to keep a track record and try to assess how was the impact. So, during these last 3 years, but four, but a year ago, we started discussing the concept about the industry innovation base. Again, mainly focusing on trying to link better all this work on the value of information to the real economy. So this was a concept that was introduced, and it's been very active. And it will be active to the end of the construction. So the idea here, just briefly to explain, was basically trying to make a jump from our construction to industry and trying to establish and strengthen the communication on the supply chain. So, as I can present here in this figure, so pushing from academia and research-based institutes to ultimately, however, that it's the society in general. So, from academia, passing through manufacturers, concessionaires, owners, government authorities, ultimately trying to push this into effectively in society. So, this was, we have been working actively on this concept. And there's an official lobby related to this, which is the records. Last version is on September this year. And we are updating continuously with new activities that we are preparing as well until the end of the construction. So the idea is how to translate this value of SHM to stakeholders, or as a decision maker, that they need to decide to sign some document and take the responsibility and try to see how this work can support. is a promotional video, a trailer, a teaser that's available on the web. So you can see, or at least we try to also publicize these with trying to show evidence that in this specific workshop, the main audience were not perhaps as it is here, more research based, but they were more industry based. So you can Google it and you can have a VPN, etc. Also, we are trying to organize, well, we have already done one in London recently, a special session with the title Ireland in Yacht 2018 or Yacht 2019. With the title Why Invest in CGM on Civil Engineering Infrastructures? So a catchy title, trying to push the attention of these decision makers to attend this special session. So trying to show evidence of the benefit on their, let's say, structures in the language that's not so technical, but it's more based, cost-based, let's say. As I said, and following the workshop that was on in Lisbon, the audience, the target audience is mainly authorities and owners. On both these both special sessions, the papers submitted only focus on real structures, so they are not, let's say, exploratory work. Based on some laboratorial tests, no, it's only and mainly focused on real structures. Also, again, written in a style that is easy, or at least not so difficult, to read from an industry perspective. And we have been promoting as well formal joint collaborations, even for the special sessions, the participation. Not only people from research, but also from the industry to go to the special session and perhaps even present the work jointly with the researchers that are pushing this case study. The first one, as I said, was in last September. Dominic shared the session. We had a brief discussion. He told me that we need to do more work, I think. Which is fair, and this is something that we are starting doing, trying to change, which is not very common for a special session that is for industrial partners, mainly on this conference. Although EAPS is already a little bit more practical, but it's dominated by researchers and professors. But I think we are, at least from our macro session in Germany, we are going the right direction, but still in progress. So the next episode will be in Yams 2019, the next year, March, yes. So I hope that this new episode will be more successful. Also, taking the fact that we are using the same title might help you to track record on this dissemination perspective as well. And also, as mentioned yesterday by Jochen, from these two special sessions, we will promote a call for a special issue and our practice scientific job. So people can look to these two special sessions in 2018 and 2019 as a preparatory work towards a scientific publication. Since I also understand, that we have always this dimension for our real applications with the economy, but also the research perspective. And for people that have a really good idea, for example, and the journal papers is another part of the mind. Also, as was announced recently, there are open calls for people that are willing to push, let's say, our cost action beyond the time frame of this 4 years. So basically there are two calls, as I estudar para ver o que eu disse. Maybe the idea this year is to promote and support you preparing projects for the future on this basis of modern education. And the other one is trying to push it in an insemination perspective to perhaps give more awareness to industrial partners that were not so active in this construction, or even stakeholders that were not even part of the construction. But you can also try to push it, their awareness of what we have been doing this for years. So, I'm wrong, that is money to travel and to invest. Important work.
So it's to invest?
Yeah. First travel, so we can engage by means of these two calls. If you are, for example, some industrial partner that you collaborate very closely and you want some support to visit them, try to engage more effectively, perhaps try to prepare or formulate the problem and the focus on the project proposal, either by applying for funding on the Horizon 2020, or even if the partner, this is a problem not to advise, but you can engage it to be with them more effectively. You can use the first call, I think it can support you as it is defined in the conditions. Up to 4 or 5 days, you can go to the industrial partner and work with them. And not sure if it's something that you have been already perhaps thinking about, and take advantage of this power to establish a certain reason. And the second one that I mentioned is to go to the same gate and put the awareness of this industrial partner about what you are being done in this period. Another thing that the innovation committee is fully engaged, and also now more even with the industry innovation days, is preparing a technical recommendation. There is a structure that it was already presented, I think it's last week in the workshop in Lisbon. It's something that is will be presented the next. We presented, so it was first introduced in the workshop in Brisbane, and we had a very active discussion about it, and how it should be structured, what should be included, what in their perspective would be helpful for their perspective. And it will be also presented formally in the next special session in the IAPS 2019. I mean, it's all about perspective. So this is something that it is seen from my perspective as a very useful outcome and deliverable from this construction, but mainly targeting the decision makers. And finally, the deliverables in terms of the engineering deliverables of the innovation committee, but also perhaps now more mature and more objective on this concept of the research space. There is a promotional video on this concept of the research space. It's available on the YouTube. The technical recommendation, as I said, is something that the innovation community is committed to give a very clear and helpful document for this community outside of the research. I think also this is something that we need to think a little bit better, but it's something that I've been thinking. This portfolio showcase that we are progressively improving by means of this conference, hopefully with this special issue for the journal paper. I think ultimately we could try to push this also for a book. I think it will be very catchy and also very high impact if you could reach to this level that the membership is trying to also to promote is the same is by means of official channels of European Union. Then is the next year, the European industry in 2019, it happens every year. We should also, and I'm sure that the European Commission will be very happy to see this, that we can also effectively engage with their official installation channels. So, because if you look to the European Commission website, you see a lot of focus on innovation and industry. So they will be very happy, and I'm sure that even to support us to push this, and the same way also by means of their official channel. And that's it. Thank you very much. So, any questions?
Then we can probably set up a cost system and few weeks in advance so that the families can be and maybe you can say that in the constituency we also may need a lot of some approval. So let's say at least one month in advance when we can start.
So basically, we acted, I think it's the best advice I can give, proactive, take advantage of it for your benefit in terms of continuing this discussion by using this mechanism that we put available to all the community of this mechanism.
Thank you.
also perhaps put a little bit more shape to the special session. You can do the cost action till 1402. And we can we bring it for the center, for the office, and you put that there in the registration table or some places, and people in the coffee breaks, they are going through and they will see something saying there is a special session with this title and the construction. So try to push a little bit more attention during these 2-3 days of conference to people. They say, oh, that's nice, I need to see it.
I think one roll up in the entry scope is enough in a couple of slides.
Yeah.
And maybe not to name it again, special session of message channel number 3.
Oh, if I make comment on that, that was completely dependent on the organization.
Yeah, I know, but this organization was enough. And Divarage, we know some people who are organizing it, so maybe.
No, in Divarage, definitely is different.
But you are talking about if this to open calls
think also, it's just a, I'm not aware of it, but this is something that I've been thinking also since the beginning. Is this issue of value information by the research and being introduced progressively in the universities, for example, in training the students? Is there, for example, overall in Europe, working towards, for example, having a or updating some modules that just have specifically this issue of social monitoring, including this value information analysis? Because if you look more in the long run, I think we should also prepare the next generation of civil engineers to be able to use this, let's say, comfortable, because say not like a black box. So really, I think this is a changing of paradigms. So, but this is really
Many courses. So in order to share valuable information for further.
Secondly, I should have been at the other university, which introduced 10 years ago a bachelor's degree in third year on sensors and monitoring and processing as part of a civil engineering undergraduate program.
Many asked that not everybody sees this positively. You get a professor, the old fashioned professors, to say this is not a core subject, a waste of time. Which happens whenever you introduce anybody in the program or whatever. So that's one of the objectives or one of the things that this network allows to coming up from the is not only to arrive to Texas as the impact of this process, what we are doing cannot be considered as the impact of this possible because we've done it 10 years ago. But to collect this information and create this dynamic that is actually happening, this is important, and create more pressure for engineering courses to introduce this program even at the graduate level. We don't have to introduce it every time this training has to be ready, but in the awareness and understanding, it's extremely important that there will be more activity in engineering practice, more activity in research, and so on.
Is you are preparing the impact price in the short term is not so high, but in the long run, should be 5-10 years. If you keep this idea, this dimension of starting embedding this, planning a European cost action, so European Union, the European Commission funded some networking on this subject, perhaps because this is relevant. Waste money. So this way, it's because it is important for society in general. So now I'm thinking, or at least us also, as we are discussing now, how to also introduce all this discussion that was promoted during this construction, as you said, the value of information of the ESG industry is not restricted to the construction of 2022, of course, but take advantage of this movement. Construction and the European Union in support of this field, I'm sure, also to refresh a little bit the courses of civil engineering. I understand that when we start talking about sensors and hardware, it's not civil engineering, but it's not a matter of the force, the utility of this for the civil engineering structure. The value of information that we are discussing is quite wrong. The next generation of civil engineers should be really comfortable. If needed one day, I know how I should use it. I think it's the most effective way to change society by means of education. This sentence is not mine. So, a lot of people, famous people, that say this is the best and most efficient way to change society is by means of education. So if we are able to introduce this also in our degrees, I'm sure that the education to assess the impact.
Well, you're preaching to the converter. I'll say that we have introduced this year from day one of our course, and the point that I'm making was the additional point is that not everybody understands the value of these aspects. So people like us who are trying to develop methods and promote and implement it, we have more support from this community to justify this and all the aspects. So this will be a very important impact.
Perhaps for your side, if I'm understanding correctly, you can also use this visibility of this construction to justify to your peers here saying, please take into account that the European level is giving money to promote this networking and these experts. So I think it's justified why we are trying, I think, putting this since the beginning, so it gives you strength to keep it in, and I think you are in the right direction.
This
right.
Is an important channel of impact in the whole cycle.
Yes.
Want to say something?
Or more questions?
So if there is no more questions, thank you very much.
Feel free to contact the Innovation Committee, mainly for this door call. So if you are interested, just drop an email, and we are more than happy to support you.
From my side,
thank you.
How often regarding the sports, so we have been writing this call and the deadline, so we need to write here
this
slow. And we also need to write that at least 1 month it was noise.
So we should actually send the email.
Yes.
And we find an update on the deadline.
Yes.
One month. So you suggest maybe we can discuss this.
Yeah.